You can integrate Oracle Identity Cloud Service with your on-premise identities currently stored in Microsoft Active Directory. The Identity Bridge component of Oracle Identity Cloud Service enables synchronization of all identities and groups from Active Directory into its own identity store residing in the cloud. In addition, you can implement federated single sign-on between cloud and on-premise applications by configuring Active Directory as an identity provider using the SAML 2.0 open standard. First, let's synchronize users from your Microsoft Active Directory with the Oracle Identity Cloud Service by installing the Identity Bridge. This enables you to set up a unidirectional synchronization from Active Directory to Oracle Identity Cloud Service. Log into the console as an administrator and select Download and Configure from the Directory Integration section. After selecting Add a Microsoft Active Directory Bridge, you are presented with a client ID and secret. This is the credential which allows the Identity Bridge agent to communicate securely with Oracle Identity Cloud Service. We will use the client ID and secret later in the configuration. Click Download to retrieve the Identity Bridge software. Next, we install and configure the Identity Bridge. In the Specify Oracle Identity Cloud Service Credential Screen Setup wizard, enter the Oracle Identity Cloud Service URL and client ID and secret that were issued earlier. Then test the connection. In the Specify Microsoft Active Directory Credential screen, enter the username and password for Active Directory and test the connection. Once the bridge is installed, select the Active Directory bridge from Directory Integrations. Select the organization units and groups you would like to synchronize from Active Directory. In this case, let's select the employees, users, and groups. The Include Hierarchy checkbox allows you to include subgroups. The Filter field allows you to search for an organizational unit that meets a specific criteria. For example, you may only want to bring in users that have a last name as Smith or from a particular group. In the authentication settings, make sure Enabled Federated Authentication is selected and save the configuration. After saving the configuration, click Import and import the users and groups from Active Directory. Verify that the synchronization has completed successfully by clicking Refresh. Another way to verify that the synchronization is successful is to select a user from Active Directory and ensure that their entry appears in Oracle Identity Cloud Service. In this case, the user Clarence Saladner exists in both user stores. Now that we've synchronized Active Directory users with Oracle Identity Cloud Service, let's look at how to implement federated single sign-on to applications in this hybrid environment. Oracle Identity Cloud Service provides out-of-the-box integration with SAML 2.0 identity providers. The SAML 2.0 specification defines three roles: the principal, typically a user, the identity provider, and the service provider. In this example, the user csaladner@example.com is the principal, the Oracle Identity Cloud Service console is the service provider, and Active Directory the identity provider. First, register Active Directory Federation Services, or ADFS, by selecting Add Identity Provider and giving it a name such as ADIP. The next step requires us to have downloaded the federation metadata from ADFS and then to register it in the Oracle Identity Cloud Service Administration Console by clicking Upload. Select the user attributes, a name ID format, and click Next and Finish. Download the service provider metadata from this URL, so we can provide this to ADFS later in the configuration. Next, register Oracle Identity Cloud Service as a trusted reliant party in ADFS by importing the metadata downloaded previously from Oracle Identity Cloud Service. Then, add claim rules. These define what information about a logged in user is passed from ADFS to Oracle Identity Cloud Service following a successful authentication. Here we configure two claim rules for Oracle Identity Cloud Service as a relying party: email and name ID. The email rule defines that the email address from logged in users will be sent to Oracle Identity Cloud Service. The name ID rule defines that the email address will be presented as name ID to Oracle Identity Cloud Service. Now the configuration is complete, let's test the connection to our identity provider, ADFS, in the Oracle Identity Cloud Service console by selecting the test login option. Log into ADFS with a username that you imported into Oracle Identity Cloud Service from Active Directory. With the test login successful, we select Activate to enable the Active Directory Identity Provider. Now assign the Active Directory Identity Provider to an Identity Provider policy by clicking IDP Policies. You can assign either to the default Identity Provider policy or one you have previously created. Here we select the default policy, and under Identity Providers, select Assign, and then the Active Directory Identity Provider. Now, when we access the sign-in page, we are presented with two login options, the Oracle Cloud Identity Services login and the Identity Provider login. By selecting the Active Directory Identity Provider, we are presented with the ADFS login page and we can log in successfully. Oracle Identity Cloud Service allows you to leverage your existing investment in Active Directory infrastructure with a hybrid on-premise and cloud environment. You can automatically synchronize your Active Directory users with Oracle Identity Cloud Service and enable single sign-on to both on-premise and cloud applications via ADFS. To learn more about what you have seen in this video, please visit our tutorials. Thank you for watching.